Morphy Morphy, Zeke here.
Do you like misery and want to share it with other people? Or have you ever wanted to play Stalker in multiplayer and getting ripped apart by black holes? Then I got a solution for you. StalkerCraft is a free-to-play MMO FPS where you can push the limits of your frustration tolerance. Probably everyone knows by now the story behind Chernobyl, but in case you live under a rock, the nuclear power plant worker over there did a little bit of crawling that resulted in one of the best never-dying memes of all time. Story. Alright, I haven't finished the main story for one reason that I will tell you later. And I mainly skipped the dialogue because I had no interest in that. But you're some kind of chosen one that are called blessed, and you were called by the zone to find something here. Just the average stalker experience. The intro mission is basically Fallout New Vegas because it was a rigged game from the start. The game originally started as a Minecraft mod that wanted to bring the stalker experience into multiplayer mode, hence the look of the game. But the developer noticed that there's more potential to make money with a complete game than just a simple mod. So they hid in their basement for 7 years and emerged from the man cave after the game was ready to launch in the NA and EU. And the result was the bastard child between Minecraft, Stalker and Escape from Tarkov as a stepmom. I won't talk anymore about the story, just let me give you one advice on the way. Normally I'm against guides or walkthroughs, but in this case, play it only with a complete story guide, otherwise you will get a brain aneurysm trying to do the main quests. Gameplay. Before you can start playing the game, you need to create a character that will learn the meaning of death and rebirth through your actions. You can choose to ally either with the Stalker or the Bandits, and later on with a specific faction within. We obviously chose the Bandits, our morals aligned more with them. If you're an honorable Stalker, you would collect the backpack of a fellow Stalker and try to return it back to them. If you're a Bandit, well, it would be a shame if you died in my close proximity with all of your stuff. That also includes teammates. Now look. We are not bad people, we just roleplay as bandits. Even if we would love to return all the artifacts and ammunition, but unfortunately, we can't. The game is a semi-open world where different instances are divided with loading screens. The limiting factor why you can't explore the high-end areas in the game is the radiation. To survive there, you first need a better suit. Sometimes you meet camper at the entrance, but luckily you're invincible for a few seconds and you can just chase them down and kill them without hesitation. But the most common cause of death won't be the enemy faction, or the mutants, or the aimbot NPCs, no. It will be the anomalies. Some are more dangerous than other. You have your electro or flame anomalies that hurt you a bit, but that's it, and are pretty easy to spot. Then you have your middle class anomalies that are a bit more difficult to spot and can cause more damage, like the trampoline anomaly. And then you have your top tier class anomalies, like the vortex, and the king of all anomalies, the black hole. It is the king for one special reason. Once you get close enough, you will get the biggest suck of your life, because there's no escape from it. Just accept your fate and look in the faces of other bandits that are going to take your shit in a few seconds when you die. Or the stasis anomalies that are... There are several world events like the different mutant dens. You have the dog or the bloodsucker dens that need to be cleared out. And then there are also the enemy faction camps that need to be exterminated. Or you have your more creative ones, like the anomaly rifts, where you need to run around and try not to die. Or the Yuja board computer, where you summon the spirits of your ancestors and explain to them why your wife is a 2D PNG. Unfortunately, killing mutants is prohibited in our world, so we gotta make do in the game. PvP is also a big role in the game, because you can meet players from enemy faction everywhere in the world, even in front of your base. You're only safe in the cities from being killed by other players. In these cities, you can sell your items, research artifacts, and craft or upgrade your weapons and suit. Every few hours, the NATO preemptively starts bombing the area for being so radioactive just to prevent the creation of Anime 2. Nah, these are just the missions. They start without a warning, and you only have a short amount of time to get to safety before you start to constantly take damage that will kill you. Oh, and also every time one starts, the chat goes completely apeshit. Let me give you an example what the normal StalkerCraft experience feels like. And then we finish it off with a critique.
Thank you.
critique. The game is very inconsistent. By that I mean the gameplay aspects of it. While you have your good action fights and exploration aspects like in Stalker, where you can even find hidden NPCs in the bushes that will give you quests, you also have a main story quest, which is, to put it lightly, complete fucking bullshit. It's not good designed or executed. Several missions force you to play some kind of Minecraft Mirror's Edge edition with shitty parkour mechanics and some horrendous boss fights that will take you hours to beat if you're not prepared, and even then, it's up to RNGesus if you don't get killed while doing so, and then you can start from the beginning. If you ever wanted to suffer with a few friends in a game that is as close as it gets to a Stalker multiplayer, then you can go ahead and inflict pain on your soul. Just beware that the soul potential is through the roof. And with these words, I hope you liked the video, and have a nice day. Goodbye!